Hey, what's up everyone, and once again welcome back to Super Smash Brothers Melee. It has been a very long time, and by a very long time I mean like a month or two, I'm not sure. Anyway, last time we took on Adventure Mode with Young Link, which is who is right here, I think it was Young Link anyway, and this time we are going to be taking on with Pichu. Input my name, and last time I checked we used the backpack, which I didn't realize was a backpack at first. I thought that it was a cape, but no, it's a backpack. This time I'm gonna go ahead and use I'm gonna use the red one, this little ribbon thing, because generally when I play Pichu I choose these goggles, which are adorable by the way, but I kind of want to use this. So let's go. I guess the main thing I'm gonna at least mention, I'm just going to turn my TV up actually, this is quieter than I thought it was. There we go. Where Melee's been. I know it has been a while, and if you guys saw my update video the other day, I kind of explained why. Well, it was like a week ago at this point, but essentially, like, I was catching up on my daily vlogs, which you can find the link to in the description below, by the way. Oh, and I forgot that Pichu deals damage to himself. That's always fun, isn't it? Whoopsie. But yeah, I was catching up on the daily vlogs. And, I'm dead. Yep, it's been a while since I played Melee, guys. I forgot that the air dodge was different. And, well, you saw what just happened. Please don't kill me. Okay, I just gotta get used to this again. I probably should have played a couple matches, like, beforehand, but oh well. I'm gonna spam Thunder for this team match. But yeah, so I was catching up, and the Let's Plays basically had to take a backseat, really. Whilst I caught up on them. But the vlogs are caught up, so LPs are returning. Also, dat up smash. Oosh! Oosh? Okay. Alright, okay, you need to go. Come on. And he's still alive. Catch this Thunder? No? Come on. There we go. Up air to victory. Whoa. A lot has happened in the vein of Smash Bros. Since I, also, Peach is really fast. Since the last video. Mainly just in the fact that, if you guys remember several episodes ago, or maybe it was the last episode, I can't honestly remember. I was talking about, like, characters I want to see return as DLC to Smash 4. And, well, obviously, Mewtwo was confirmed. Mewtwo, you will have already seen the Mewtwo video at this point. If you haven't, it's the video that was uploaded before this one. Me playing as Mewtwo. Which, spoilers, I'm actually recording this video before that one, so I have no idea what will have happened. Also, I'm doing so badly. This is exactly what happened when I started up Adventure Mode, just because I was rusty. But I don't remember it being this tough, but I guess that was once I'd already recorded several episodes of it. Are you serious? Clearly, again, just used to Smash 4, because I've been playing Smash 4 so much more recently. Okay, if you could do the roll that. Oh, that's not there anymore. Okay, I guess it's mainly about aerials and stuff, and just because Melee has, like, more combos than the other Smash games. Like, to do more damage, you just gotta connect with combos and whatnot. But I'm gonna keep hitting with this up air, because it seems to have a lot of knockback. Plus, it's a move that doesn't do damage to Pichu, so that's always a bonus. Right, come on. But yeah, of course, Mewtwo's coming back. Well, Mewtwo is back at this point. At least for Club Nintendo users. Alright, you know what? That's got no range. And that. Oh my god, seriously? Okay, I thought that I was gonna lose all three stocks on the second level, which would not be fun. Alright. Are you serious? I mean, I know Pichu is like the lowest tier character, but still. Also, it's seriously gonna make me do Mushroom Kingdom again. I'm just gonna cut to the Mario and Peach fight. Okay, let's do a little better this time. I'm gonna just not try spamming smash attacks. I think, honestly, the reason I was just spamming smash attacks and hoping that they walked into me is because I recently completed the challenge on Smash Wii U where you've got to beat All-Star on hard mode with all the characters. And oh my god, it took me so long. I'll probably talk about that in a little bit. But the main one that was like really tough for me, oops,
come on,
was freaking, what's it called? Olimar and Villager. They were really tough. Also, that was so much better now that I'm just focusing on actually moving around a lot and stuff like that. But yeah, I'll talk about that in a bit. Once I finally get out what I was wanting to say, Lucas is returning from Brawl as DLC. Not for a while, I believe it's like June or July that he's actually coming back. Which is, in retrospect, that's only like a couple of months, so that's actually pretty soon, I suppose. Although Mewtwo, well, for you guys, is already out, so you future people enjoying Mewtwo, I'm jealous. But anyways, home run bat. I forgot how different the home run bat looked in the old games, but okay, we got the kill with it. But yeah, so I'm excited, definitely excited for Lucas. I'm hoping it's out by now, because it's been a while, but my friend Sean, okay, he was going to be releasing a reaction video that we did. He basically recorded our Skype call while we were watching the Nintendo Direct. You know, when Mewtwo was shown off and they revealed Lucas, and I was not expecting Lucas whatsoever. I don't think many people were, to be honest. Just because Sakurai had said he was only doing the Mewtwo DLC, he said that he specifically said we are not going to be adding any more characters. But he lied because we knew that it took way too long for Mewtwo. Like, Sakurai, like, it was several months between hearing about Mewtwo to start with and then actually getting a reveal. Also, convenient first room Triforce. And after he'd said, like, we're only working on Mewtwo, it wouldn't have taken that long for them to work on Mewtwo, especially since it looks like he's keeping it as his entire melee moveset. So, I seriously doubt that it took that long to just copy him over. Well, it didn't, because they were adding Lucas as well. And I imagine that in the background, they're also possibly working on other characters. So that'll be the little comment question thing, even though I'm fairly certain it was one a couple episodes ago, geez. Who do you think? Oh, no, hold up, I'll make it a different one. Because they also opened up the Smash Bros. Ballot thing, where you can basically vote for what character you want to see in the game. I voted for Roy, because at the time I was just like, okay, we got Mewtwo, we got Lucas, I was just thinking veterans. So I chose Roy, because I would like to see Roy come back. And I think he's got a okay chance, I guess, but afterwards people said, like, people have been voting for King K. Rool, which I believe he's really high up in the polls right now. As well as Shovel Knight is pretty high up, and I believe Banjo-Kazooie. I don't know if they're high up or not, but, like, some dude who works at Microsoft, maybe, like, the head of Microsoft or something, said that he would like to see Banjo-Kazooie in the game. So, that's pretty cool. Okay, please recover. I keep forgetting that in Melee, you can't grab a ledge if you're facing away from it. But this up air is, like, okay, this up air is what's been, like, winning these games for me.
No, I want that.
Boom! Alright, I was kind of hoping to... There's a ba-bomb right there as well. I was kind of hoping to hit the ba-bomb up top and take Samus with the ba-bomb, but no, that didn't happen. Please don't shoot me. Alright, I'm gonna just get you with an up tilt, pick up a screw attack and throw it at you. And down B! Oh god, okay. Okay. Samus, please don't hit me with that. I'm just gonna keep juggling you in the air. Don't you dunk me. Don't you try dunk me. Oh, that was actually a pretty good combo. Don't you dunk me. No dunk. No dunk 5U. Trying to, like, bait the air dodge so that I can actually hit Samus with a different move. Oh, that'll do it. Nope. Air dodge. Alright. Air dodge right above the ground. Alright. I feel like she wants that food. There. I've eaten the food. Are you sad now? Are you gonna die yet? Please get out. No. No heart container for you. Or Maxim Tomato. Alright, come on. Are you serious? I've just got to hit with a thunder. Oh, I did hit with that thunder. Okay, you know what? You know what? Come here, Samus. Come on. Come on, we're going to hit you with an up smash. I want to kill you with an up smash. Whoa. I think that was a back air. Come on, I don't want the stage to kill you, I want to do it. Oh, home run bat, hello. No. Okay, Samus is just going up there. We're gonna just go, boop. That'll do. But yeah, my comment question for you guys is, who did you vote for in the Smash Bros. Character ballot? As I said, I voted Roy. I hadn't voted for Roy. It's just now that I've thought about it, there's a lot more characters I think I could have voted for. Simply because, like, I was just in the moment. I was like, oh, I want Roy back. I wasn't thinking, like, who else would I like to see, like, newcomer-wise. Also, that was a freaking flawless run of that. Boom. There we go. Done. That was a really good run of that stage. So yeah, I think, obviously, the most popular ones, like I said, are like King K. Rool. And to be honest, I would like to see King K. Rool from the Donkey Kong Country series, because Donkey Kong does not have enough representatives in Smash yet. There's just Donkey Kong and Diddy Kong. Okay, you could do that. And I think K. Rool or Dixie Kong, more likely, I feel K. Rool would be the better additions, and the one that, oh, you know, I feel like K. Rool would be the most likely out of the two, and I just tried to do a down smash with the C-stick, and you can't in single player. Okay, I'm gonna move. I've been watching, like, some competitive Melee stuff, and it just makes me sad, because I'm so bad at anything relating to competitive Melee, I know, like, nothing about. It's just fun to watch. And I think, like, Mewtwo King or someone uses Pichu sometimes. So that's pretty cool. But yeah, so I guess that's me done talking about the freaking character ballot. But as for the other characters, well, I guess as for the other characters I would have voted for, I can see me voting for King K. Rool just because of the reasons I just expressed. Banjo-Kazooie just because it's freaking Banjo-Kazooie. Banjo-Kazooie, Banjo-and-Kazooie, however they'd put it in-game. I guess they would probably just say Banjo-Kazooie just to stick with it. I doubt that they'd have the name as Banjo-and-Kazooie. Even though that would make more sense, I guess. I just don't see them doing that if they were to add them. Rayman, just because of the whole artsy Omni thing. If you haven't seen that, oh, hello. We must have beaten that in 30 seconds. The Artsy Omni Rayman League, if you guys didn't see that. I guess that's another thing that I could talk about, even though I have actually spoken about that on my vlog. I guess I could talk about it in Melee here. Come on, go there. Okay, stop just jabbing me, plus. Okay, this Kirby kind of knows what he's doing. Or he doesn't, and he's just spamming the same move. Says me, who's just using up tilts and up airs and neutral airs. Alright, come on, there we go. Okay, first stock lost. Well, that's actually not bad, seeing as though on the first attempt, I did lose all three by the second stage. So, I'm fine with only just losing the first one. Alright, I need to get away from that Togepi. Oh, it's turning the stage dark. Okay, and I'm getting hit. I don't know which way I just got launched. I was too low. I hate when Togepi does that. Also, I hate it because I'm fairly certain that the CPUs can still see. I'm dead. Are you kidding me? Continue. We just lost three stocks on the giant Kirby stage. And we're going to have to fight the Team Kirby again. So, I'm going to cut to the end of this because you guys don't want to see that. Okay, well, I didn't beat that in under 30 seconds this time, so we're not fighting Giant Kirby. To be honest, I'm not bothered. I didn't want to fight Giant Kirby again. And I decided to cut there just because in older Melee videos, I would, like, leave in the fails. I mean, I left in the fail, but I would then leave in me trying to get back to where I was, and to be honest, that just kind of makes the videos run on for longer. Please stop. So I just decided to cut it. And if this fox could stop running, I forgot that this guy just runs from, like, everything. It's stupid, but that's what he does, so. Ooh, a fan. This could actually come in handy. Are you gonna just stay over there? That hurts me. I don't know why I did that. Nope. Alright, okay, this isn't fair. I hate Melee. I didn't just say that. I like Melee. I hate that I'm bad at it. I didn't mean to say, I don't know why I said I hate melee. I hate this fox though, because he's just running from everything I'm doing. This isn't how you play Smash Bros, Fox. You don't just run, you fight. It's kind of the whole idea of the game. There we go. That was pretty good on my part. I'm proud of that. Just jumping in the air and throwing the capsule down at him. But yeah, the whole Artsy Omni thing with the Rayman leak, he basically made an entire leak where he made a model for Rayman and did it in the style of Smash 4 and all that kind of stuff. It was really well done, and then he made like a bunch of fake images, but then he like sealed the deal by making a fake video. He like used After Effects and stuff to actually put together a video of the character select screen with Mewtwo and Rayman on it. And, like, everybody pretty much believed that it was real. I mean, I didn't 100% believe it, I just really wanted it to be real. Turns out it wasn't, of course, but apparently since then, Ubisoft has actually said that they're, like, pushing to get Rayman in the game. So, that would be pretty awesome if they actually added him, but again, well, not again, I haven't said it yet, but he's third party. And we've got three third-party characters in Mega Man, Sonic, and Pac-Man, and I don't think Sakurai would add another one. And I forgot that there was just a bunch of Pokeballs here, so I was just, like, attacking them. Zapdos, hello, do me a favor, there we go. Oh, that didn't kill. Also, I'm fairly certain that Staryu Pokeball made no noise. Come on, Snorlax. There we go. Honestly, I was probably doing better when just fighting them as me. Like, without using the Pokeballs, because I was, like, hitting several of them as they came down. Maybe I should just go back to doing that. Oh, you're so screwed. Oh, there's another one. Oh, he's dead. No, he's not dead. Alright, there we go. I'm gonna get one last Pokeball, hit you. What do we got? Blastoise. Come on, Blastoise. No, okay, Pikachu could just jump into Blastoise. That works too. Who else did I? Who else was I gonna say? People have been asking for, like, Wonder Red from Wonderful 101. Personally, the only thing I've played of Wonderful 101 is the demo, which I've actually done a Let's Demo on if you want to see that. You can find that in the Let's Demo playlist, but that's the only thing I've played of Wonderful 101, and I haven't really watched many videos on it. So if any of you guys have played it and you feel like Wonder Red would work as a character in Smash, then let me know and what you think of that. But from what I played in the demo, I can kind of see it working if you only really use the huge, like, arm attacks and stuff for like his final Smash or something. Or maybe they could incorporate that into Smash attacks. I'm not entirely sure because, again, I haven't played Wonderful 101 enough to really know much about it. But yeah, I think that could be a potential thing. And then of course there's people who like want Snake back, and to be honest, I liked Snake in Brawl towards the end of Brawl's life. Like, I played him a lot whenever I was recording the Smash Sundays that are still being released, just before the servers went down. I started to use him a little bit then, but I think he was only in the game because Kojima like asked Sakurai to put him in. Basically as like promotion for some Metal Gear game or something like that. I'm not entirely sure, but I seem to remember that being the case or something similar. I could be completely wrong here, but that's pretty much what I heard or what I've read. Also, please don't die, Pichu. I want to use this red shell. Go. There we go. Oh, I don't... No, you don't get to pick this up, Falcon. No, the red shell! Okay, I actually picked that up before the red shell hit me, so I'm not going to take any more damage now. And I keep trying to use the C-stick, because I'm an idiot, and I need to remember that I'm playing Super Smash Bros. Melee, not Super Smash Bros. For Wii U. Also, I was just about to use a neutral air. That would have hit that bomb and probably killed me. Oh well. So, I've spent the last 22 minutes talking about DLC in Smash 4 and the fighter ballot, so that's nice. In fact, Mr. Saturn, something I didn't know about Mr. Saturn, he breaks shields. Maybe I've spoken about this in a previous Melee episode, but I'm fairly certain I only discovered it recently. If you throw Mr. Saturn at someone who's got their shield up, it will break the shield and they'll be stunned. I honestly didn't know that until recently, so... That... I don't know. I don't know why. I always thought Mr. Saturn was just an item for, like, throwing at people and getting minimal damage, but now that I know he's actually used for breaking shields, it added a lot more to the item, in my opinion. Like, it feels like it's not quite as pointless. Okay, you need to go. Is that gonna do it? That's gonna do it. And up. Up air. Nope. Up air? Up air. Up air. Honestly, looking at this stage after playing Smash 4, it really doesn't look that much different. Which I know might seem odd, but it doesn't look like they updated it that much in Smash 4 going back to Melee. Maybe they didn't. Maybe they just updated it slightly, but the graphics of this stage, I mean, they look great in Melee. But, I don't know, they look only slightly better in Smash 4. Yeah, these Nessas just focus on the Mr. Saturn, so I've just got the time to hit them with all the up airs I want. And the Thunder. There we go. Weird thing, the quality that you're seeing, like, how Melee looks on your end right now watching this video, is actually a little better than what I see, because of course I'm looking at my TV. My TV is a flat screen, and this game was originally designed with, like, CRT TVs in mind. So, the image on my screen looks kind of pixely, and that hurt. And stuff, but if I look at the recording window, because it's just, like, capturing it at the exact aspect ratio and all that, it looks like basically how you guys are gonna see it, or how you guys are seeing it. So, interesting little thing that I maybe touched on before, but I didn't quite realize why it did that for a while. And then my dad just explained, like, oh, you've got a flat screen. It doesn't look quite as good because it's something to do with the pixels and the aspect ratio and all of this stuff. So, please don't kill me. Okay. So okay. Oh well, we're close to the end of adventure mode here. So, plus no kill. So, like, there's only a few stages left, so losing a stock here probably wouldn't be too bad. But I'd rather not lose a stock. Ice Climbers actually are a character that they were in a leak before the Nintendo Direct. By the way, the Nintendo Direct was on April 1st, which is pretty much the worst day that they could have possibly had a Nintendo Direct. But there was a bunch of leaks coming out, like, the day before, and there was one leak that said, like, Mewtwo and then Wolf, Lucas, and a single Ice Climber were gonna be coming back to the game. Wolf and Lucas are self-explanatory, just returning characters, but the single Ice Climber thing, because they can't get Ice Climbers to... Sakurai couldn't get Ice Climbers to work on the 3DS version, for whatever reasons. I'm guessing just technical limitations. Although, if he can get Rosalina and Luma to work on the 3DS version, I don't believe that he failed to get friggin' Ice Climbers working, because the Ice Climbers seem, like, less, I guess, CPU-intensive, wow, than Rosalina and Luma, because you basically control... Well, they're almost, like, the same, except I feel like with Luma, you control it a little more than you do with Nana, but basically, the leak stated that it would be one Ice Climber, and it would be Popo, but Nana would be a palette swap. So, I guess there would be, like, 4 Popo and 4 Nana, palette swaps. Which... To be honest, I'd rather have that than no Ice Climbers whatsoever. But I don't see it happening. I don't think that Sakurai would do that, just because, for example, if they have better hardware for the next Smash game, and they decide that they're going to want to add Ice Climbers back, and they've just had them as a single character, would they go back to having them as a pair? I feel like maybe they wouldn't. Also, please don't pick that up. Okay, come on. Walk into me. And you, sir? What? No, I can't do the smash attack. Come on. Can I please kill you? Come on. Nope. Oh my god, I'm dead. Okay. Okay, come on. Invincibility frames, and apparently I hit that on the frigging back of it. But, okay. I'm doing bad with Pichu. I hope I do better with Roy, just because... Well, Roy is our final character for Adventure Mode, And I just hope I do better with him, especially since I was he's the one I voted for to come back. Also, if we die against Bowser... Okay, no, wait. If we die against Bowser, we just go straight back to Bowser. I was thinking we have to do the battlefield stages again, but it's just based on, like, stages, I think. So if we die on Bowser, we just fight Bowser again, from what I can recall. And I don't doubt that we are not going to be fighting Giga Bowser, because this has been a horrendous run and I'm already dead. Because Bowser versus Pichu. When you compare them like that, and I had them next to each other just then, Pichu is so tiny compared to Bowser. Whoa. And I don't know. That just got me thinking about Ridley, who is also... look at this. Look how small Pichu is compared to Bowser. And of course, I was going to get hit there. This is... Oh, well, I guess that isn't regular-sized Bowser. The adventure mode Bowser is a little bigger. For whatever reason. He just ground-pounded a frigging bomb. But still. Like, if Ridley was this size, I think that would work. But then they won't add Ridley. If Sakurai puts Ridley as a playable character, then I don't know what to think. Because... Well, for one, he's already in the game as a frigging stage boss. So he just wouldn't do that. That's like putting the Yellow Devil as a playable character. But I believe Ridley is a popular choice in the Smash ballot. So, well, of course he is. Freaking everybody and their mother wants Ridley. But... Well, except me. I really have no opinion towards Ridley being in Smash. Sure, he didn't do his up B. All right, you know what? I'm just gonna pick this up and die. There we go. 29 minutes. So that's actually like around about that. Actually, that's with cuts as well. So that's actually a pretty quick run. Because I cut some stuff out and I skipped the frigging thing. I skipped that so many times in these videos, and I apologize if you wanted to see it. But there we go. Adventure mode with Pichu done. Sorry if you've heard, like, scratching sounds throughout this video. My neck is itching, it's weird, so... And my face is, like, right by the microphone, so I don't know if you will have heard it. But, yeah, there we go. Melee, it's back, and we've only got, like, one more episode of Adventure mode left. That's kind of adorable. Anyway, interesting thing. You got the Pichu trophy. Is the time wrong again? Let me see. No, the time is actually right. Interesting. Oh, wait. Wait, no, it isn't. No, it's currently 7:45, so it's like 25 minutes off. Or, no. No, that's the seconds. It's 5 minutes off. Okay, interesting. It actually fixed itself. Anyway, let's go ahead and take a look at the Pichu trophy. Now, what I was going to say is this is the first episode of Melee that's actually going to be edited in Adobe Premiere because I've switched editing software from Sony Vegas to Adobe Premiere. So, yeah. I'm going to go all the way down and Pichu Smash. Pichu Smash! Compared with Pikachu, Pichu is a tad more nimble and a little more difficult to hit. Those are the only two advantages, however, as since Pichu damages itself when it uses electrical attacks, it's best suited for handicapped matches. Even though Pichu's tough to catch, it's easy to throw its tiny frame great distances. B is Thunder Jolt, and Smash, or Side B, is Skull Bash. So, that is going to do it for this video. Next time on Super Smash Bros. Melee, we are going to be taking on Adventure Mode for the 25th and final time, using my boy Roy. So thank you all for watching, stay tuned for the next episode, and I'll see you guys then.